السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. ميرو نصرور، كيمستري تيتشر. Our topic today, prevention of metal corrosion. What is corrosion? Corrosion is a natural galvanic process by which the refined metal convert into more chemically stable form such as oxide, hydroxide or sulfide. It is a gradual destruction of materials, usually metals, by chemical and or electrochemical reaction with their environment. Ways to prevent metal corrosion. We have to prevent galvanic oxidation of iron to prevent its corrosion. Number one, galvanic corrosion can't occur when no electrically conductive joint between metals. Separate the two metals with insulators. Number two, galvanic corrosion can't occur when no difference in the reduction potential between metals. The two metals are similar or nearly equal in reduction potential. Number three, galvanic corrosion can't occur when no connection between metals and electrolyte by coating one metal or the two metals. Or the electrolyte surrounded one metal, not the other. Ways to prevent metal corrosion. The corrosion prevention by coating. The protective coatings. Coating is the thin layer of a covering substance deposited or applied on a surface of any object, mainly to improve its critical properties and to create a protective barrier against corrosion of the surface due to its reaction with its environment. The protective coating types. Based on the use of physical barrier to separate the metal surface from the environment. There are four types. Metallic coating, conversion coating, inorganic coating, or paints. Types of the metallic coating. Number one, cathodic coating or the anodic protection. Number two, the anodic coating or the cathodic protection. Number three, multi-layer coating as nickel chrome coatings. Number four, zinc coating or galvanizing. Number four, tin coating as in food production. Nickel coating, chromium coating, copper coating, precious metals coating. The cathodic coating or anodic protection. Anodic protection involves coating the iron with a less active metal, such as tin. Tin will not corrode, so the steel will be protected as long as the tin coating is in place. This method is known as anodic protection because it makes the steel the anode of an electrochemical cell. Cathodic coating involve coating the iron with a less active metal to act as a cathode against iron that acts as anode to protect the iron from corrosion. Iron coating by a metal less active than iron, so the iron is act as anode and the less active metal is act as cathode. The anode coating or the sacrificial anode or the cathodic protection. Cathodic protection, it is the coating of iron with a more active metal which corrode to prevent the corrosion of the steel. This method is known as cathodic protection because it works by making the steel the cathode of an electrochemical cell. The anodic coating or the sacrificial anode or the cathodic protection. Cathodic protection, it is the coating of iron with a more active metal which corrodes to prevent the corrosion of the steel. This method is known as cathodic protection because it works by making the steel the cathode of the electrochemical cell. The anodic coating metal as zinc, aluminium or cadmium. The anodic coating called sacrificial coating because it acts as anode to the iron or steel which corrodes while the steel is protected. Iron coating by metal more active than iron, so the iron will be cathode and the more active metal will be anode. Sacrificial anodes are highly active metals that are used to prevent the corrosion of the less active metal surface. Sacrificial anodes are created from a metal with a more negative electrochemical potential than iron, as magnesium, zinc or aluminium. Cadmium is a metallic coating used as sacrificial coating to protect iron from corrosion. When both cadmium and iron are exposed to a corrosive media, cadmium will form cadmium ions which react with oxygen in the corrosive media or in air to form cadmium hydroxide layer which diminishes further corrosion. So, cadmium protect iron by both sacrificial corrosion mechanism and cadmium hydroxide film barrier corrosion protective mechanism. The cathodic protection types. By making the iron the cathode in an electrochemical cell, there are two types. Number one, galvanic cathodic protection system, in which the iron acts as cathode connected with anode made of a metal that has high oxidation potential or less reduction potential than iron. The two metals make a galvanic cell. The second type, the embraced current cathodic protection system, in which the iron acts as cathode connected with inert anode and an external electric DC power source. The two metals makes an electrolytic cell. Galvanic cathodic protection system. The embraced current cathodic protection system. The anodic and cathodic metallic coating. The cathodic coating. It is the process of coating steel or iron with a metal less active than iron as copper, nickel or silver. In this case, iron is anode and the less active metal is cathode. Anodic coating. It is the process of coating steel or iron with a metal more active than iron as zinc, aluminum or magnesium. In this case, iron is a cathode and the more active metal is anode. The reduction potential of some element that can used as a cathodic coating. The reduction potential for some metals that can use as anodic coating to iron. From this slide we can notice that the element that has positive or less negative reduction potential than iron can use as a cathodic coating. Element that has more negative than iron can used as anodic coating. Types of the metallic coating. Number 3, zinc coatings galvanization. Zinc coatings. Zinc metal has a number of characteristics that make it a well corrosion protective coating for iron and steel products. Zinc coatings called galvanization. Their performance is a function of the environmental condition and their lasting is proportional to the thickness. The galvanization protection. Galvanization or galvanizing is the process of applying a protective zinc coating to steel or iron to prevent rusting. The most common method is hot dip galvanizing, in which the parts are submerged in a bath of molten hot zinc. Zinc has the ability to form corrosion byproducts that can reduce the corrosion rate of iron, act as a protective barrier on metal surface that keep out the moisture that can speed up the corrosion process. Zinc also acts as a critical coating that protects the steel via galvanization. Zinc is more electrochemical active than iron, and when zinc and steel come in contact with each other in an electrolyte solution, the zinc serves as an anode for the steel, which will reduce iron corrosion. Nickel chrome coatings. Nickel coatings are widely used for variety of features such as mechanical resistance, hardness, ductility, as well as corrosion resistance to industrial atmosphere. Water, alkaline solution, basic molten salts and solvent, and decoration purposes. Number 5, chromium coatings. Chromium coatings are bright, hard, brittle, highly tensioned, porous if thin, and cracked if thick. Divided into main types. Thin coatings for decorative purposes and thick coating for corrosion prevention. 6. Multi-layer coating as nickel chrome coatings. It is a several identical or different layers on an iron to prevent the corrosion. Nickel chrome coatings. They are one or more layer of nickel covered by a thin layer of chromium. Iron base. A thick layer of nickel layer, chromium layer, the passive chromium oxide that resulting from the reaction between chromium layer and the oxygen of atmospheric air. How stainless steel resist corrosion? If iron and chromium are exposed to oxygen, the chromium reacts to form a very thin layer of chromium 3 oxide on the stainless steel surface as soon as exposed to the oxygen in the atmosphere. The layer of oxide is so thin that the metal can still shine through it, but it is thick enough to prevent oxygen and water attacking the metal underneath, so no corrosion takes place. The protection is permanent because even if the protective layer is scratched, the chromium in the steel will react with oxygen in the air to immediately reform the protective layer. 7. Tin coatings in food production. Tin coating is an anode protection for iron because tin is less active metal than iron. This method is known as anodic protection because it makes the iron the anode in an electrochemical cell. Tin will not corrode because tin is a less active metal. So, steel will be protected as longer as the tin coating is in place. When tin coating scratch, iron will rust faster because iron is the anode which will be oxidized. Tin coating is used in making preserved food cans. Iron covered with tin rust faster when scratching. Cover coatings. Cover provides a good level of corrosion resistance. However, it is not as effective at resisting corrosion as hard metals like nickel. For components working in a highly corrosive environment, we regularly complement copper with nickel plating. Tin, precious metals. In the past, the deposition of precious metals was limited in decorative purposes and protection of electrical contacts. Nowadays, gold deposits are widely used in electronic industry to avoid oxidation of contacts and because of good thermal and electrical conductivity. Coating is made of oxides of precious metals such as ruthenium and iridium, called mixed metal oxides, are used for anodes used in cathodic protection applications because such oxides show good resistance to aggressive environmental condition and good conductivity. Resources. At the end, thank you and goodbye.